Hi everyone, Brandon Bush here, on location from halfway around the globe. And I'm here to learn a little bit more about one of GE's newest and most environmentally impactful projects. While I'm here learning and exploring, I brought a film crew along with me so we can share it with you. Well, not yet, not actually. I'm right down the street from a house, but soon that'll all be true because my company GE is sending me to India to be one of the hosts of a new project called Powering Forward TV. Cut.
So yeah, in about a week, I'm gonna be going to India to shoot a commercial. I've got my passport, got my visa, I got stabbed a few times for some vaccinations, I even got my teeth cleaned, so I am good to go. Awesome, right? Yes. Backstory, how did I get here? A few months ago, GE put out an open call for auditions, and all you had to do was submit like a little selfie video talking about power and what inspires you. It was kind of goofy, it was kind of poorly produced, but they ended up picking me as one of five people from around the world to be host of this new series, Powering Forward TV. And the goal of this series is to kind of get the word out about some of the technologies and the projects that GE is participating in that are powering people's lives. And not just that, but projects that are helping to keep GE modern, helping to keep GE innovative, helping to keep GE competitive in this really crazy energy market. So I'm going to be stopping in a few major cities, including Delhi and Varanasi, and I'm going to be talking to people in the power industry, people on the street, trying to get a sense for what their energy goals are and how GE is helping them get there. So that'll be great, but it's only going to be a week, so it's going to be a super tight schedule. But that doesn't mean I'm not going to try to get as much touristy sightseeing stuff done as possible. So I know I've got a lot of friends that love to travel, a lot of friends from India, so please, give me your suggestions. What should I do? What should I see? What should I eat? What should I not eat? The works. So, I'm excited, but it's a bittersweet excitement, you know? Because I wish I could take my family with me. As some of you know, Candace and I used to travel a lot. But since Micah and Miles have joined the team, we've had to tone that down. A lot. And that's fine, you know, but I really hope that we can get back out there sooner rather than later. Traveling with kids is hard. And you know, we have a 10-month-old and a 2-year-old now, and I don't even know if taking some of the big trips that we really want to take right now even makes sense. But eventually, I definitely want to take them along. I think it's one of the most important things in the world for a kid to travel. But this trip, I don't think so. Micah and Miles can't come this time, and that's really a shame, because it's going to be the longest and the furthest that I've ever been away from them. But that's all right. You know, with text and phone and emails and Skype, I think we're going to be okay. Bags packed, ready to go, a whole week early. Probably because I'm so excited to get on with this adventure and share it with you. So, if you will excuse me, I was supposed to be watching Miles and I haven't seen him in a minute, so I'm gonna go find him. See you soon.